Ciao and welcome back. Today we reached the lesson number 9. Okay, you remember the last lesson, the number 8, just to refresh very fast your mind. We met a group of noun or a group of adjective, and on the singular, the word ends in e. So to understand if the word is masculine or feminine, I give you this advice. Always look at the adjective in front, because of course we are not ready yet to understand if a word is masculine or feminine. Today, in lesson number 9, we will talk how to use the noun with adjective together. For example, let's take as an example an English word. I want to say, one rich boy. One rich boy. And or two, plural, two rich boys. As you can see in English, when you change from singular to plural, the adjective that goes along the noun, rich is the adjective and boy is the noun, the adjective doesn't change in English. So it will be rich for boy and rich for boys. So only the noun change, just adding the S. In Italian is a bit different, because when you use a noun and adjective together, both of them must change from singular to plural, not only the noun, like in English. But the noun changes to plural, and also the adjective must change. The adjective always must follow the noun. If the noun is masculine, the adjective as well will be masculine. If the noun that you are going to use is feminine, also the adjective will be feminine. If the noun you are going to use is singular, the adjective will be singular. If the noun you're going to use is plural, also the adjective will be plural. One peculiarity of Italian language, different from English. Okay, we can start from this example, one rich boy. You remember how to say boy? We used some lesson ago. Ragazzo. Ragazzo. The last letter is O. So the noun is feminine singular, and rich is this one, ricco. So if you open the dictionary how to say rich, you will find ricco, masculine singular, ricca, feminine singular, ricchi, masculine plural, and ricche for feminine plural. So, one rich boy, un, masculine, ragazzo ricco, un ragazzo ricco. I have two options in Italian when I use noun and adjective together. I can write the noun first, and then the adjective will follow, or I can follow English style. I can write un ricco ragazzo. Both of them are correct. It's up to you. You can choose to say or to write the name first, and then the adjective will follow. You can write the adjective first, and then the noun will follow. Both of them are correct. Of course, in English it would be weird to say one boy rich. No, the adjective always is in front of the noun. In Italian, no, up to you. As we say, now this is singular. One, un ragazzo ricco, or un ricco ragazzo. The translation in English will be the same. One rich boy. Now let's go to due, two. I want to say two rich boys. In English, the adjective rich doesn't change. But in this case, in Italian, you have to change not only the word ragazzo, that will become ragazzi, from singular to plural, but also the adjective ricco will become in plural. So, how to say due? Due ragazzi, ragazzo, un ragazzo, due ragazzi, ricco, un ricco, due ragazzi ricchi. Due ricchi ragazzi will be the same. You remember in lesson number 8 when we use the word elegante, because the pronunciation is the same if I refer to a guy or to a girl. Un elegante without apostrofo, I refer to a man. But if I say un apostrofo elegante, I refer to a woman. In talking, of course, the pronunciation is the same. So how to understand if I refer to a guy or to a girl? I want to say now, for example, one elegant boy and one elegant girl. Since the adjective elegante the adjective elegante belongs to the group that the last letter is E, elegante, you can refer to a masculine noun or to a feminine noun. So I will say, un elegante ragazzo, one elegant boy, un with apostrofo, un elegante ragazza, one elegant boy, one elegant girl. You see, the word elegante, because of this special group of adjectives that ending in E, I can use with a masculine noun or end with a feminine noun. Un elegante ragazzo, un elegante ragazza. One elegant boy, one elegant girl. Of course, I can say ragazzo in front, because as I say, in Italian you can choose. The adjective can be in front of the noun or after the noun. So it's my choice to say un ragazzo elegante. If I want to say ragazza elegante, then I will say una ragazza elegante. Now I want to change into plural and I want to say two elegant boys and two elegant girls. As we say in the lesson number eight, in Italian, when you change from singular to plural, not only the nouns must be changed into plural, but also the adjective. So, if you have this formula always in front of you, it will be much easier. Un is one. Let's go to due. Everything must change into plural. Elegante, singular, plural eleganti. Ragazzo, singular, plural ragazzi. So the word, the sentence will become due eleganti ragazzi. Due. This one is over. I take a new one. Due. Due eleganti ragazzi. Two elegant boys. Let's go now and say two elegant girls. Due. What is the plural of elegante? Is eleganti as well. So, due eleganti, due eleganti ragazze. So, don't be surprised when you use noun and adjective together. Not always. The word of the letter of the adjective and the letter of the noun must be the same. Like in this case, eleganti ragazzi, the last letter is E and E. But look when I use the feminine. Eleganti, the last letter is E, but here the last letter is E, because the plural of ragazza is ragazze, but the plural of the adjective elegante is always eleganti, for masculine and for feminine. I now want to draw your attention on, for example, the color. The color, also the color are adjective. You want to know how to say red. You open the dictionary and you find this word. Rosso, for masculine singular, but you will say rossa if you refer to something feminine singular. Rossi, plural masculine, and rosse for plural feminine. Same for example, yellow. Giallo, gialla, gialli, gialle. Or for example, blue, azzurro, azzurro, azzurra, azzurri, azzurre. For example, you remember how to say car, one car, macchina. Feminine name. I want to say one red car, one blue car, or one yellow car. Since the word macchina is feminine, so because the last letter is A, macchina, also the adjective must follow the same gender. So macchina rossa, red car, or rossa macchina is the same. Macchina gialla, yellow car, or gialla macchina. If I want to say blue car, macchina azzurra, or azzurra macchina. As you can see, the adjective and the noun are of the same gender, must be of the same gender. Masculine with masculine, feminine with feminine. Let's go to plural. Macchine. For esempio, due macchine rosse, two red car, due macchine gialle, due macchine azzurre, red, yellow, blue. There is one color that, if you want to know how to say green, most of the color follow at this, rosso, rossa, rossi, rosse, for example, white, you open the dictionary and you will find bianco, bianco, bianca, bianchi, bianche, but there is one color that is green, green, and your dictionary will give you this word, verde, verde, like my shirt, verde. Since the adjective ending in E, the word verde for singular, plural verdi, the adjective verde green, you will use with something masculine, but also with something feminine. Let's take, for example, macchina. again, macchina, feminine noun, macchina verde. But let's take now something masculine. For example, occhio. Occhio, if you remember, is one eye. Un occhio, one eye. Un occhio verde, one green eye, if somebody has a green eye. Plural, occhi verdi. So the plural of occhio, masculine noun, occhio, occhi. The plural of verde, verde, verdi. So occhi verdi or verdi occhi is the same. Now, let's go back to the feminine noun. Macchina verde, una macchina verde, one green car. Plural now, due, the plural of macchina is macchine, due macchine verdi, o due verdi macchine. I will upload some exercise in order for you to make practice in how to change from singular to plural and how to put together a noun with an adjective. Just remember the most important thing is if you use a masculine noun, the adjective also must be masculine. If you use a feminine noun, also the adjective must be feminine. So the same gender. Noun and adjective in the same sentence must have the same gender. I think I already reached a little bit more than the promised 15 minutes. This is the end of lesson number 9. Please proceed with the exercise and I will see you again for lesson number 10. Ciao and arrivederci. Arrivederci means bye-bye, goodbye, see you again.